So hello and welcome back to AutoCAD tutorials. In today's session, we are going to see further our beams to how to make their BBS. So today we will also see that how we can enter our formula in Excel sheet. So for that, let us first consider our beam 141. As we can see in the drawing, beam 141 is a secondary beam which is resting on two of the beams, that is B7 and B1. So this becomes a secondary beam. So we have a general detail of secondary beam over here. We can see that this secondary beam doesn't have any kind of horizontal links that we have seen earlier in first video. Also, we have a particular here, something is written, minimum anchorage as specified but not less than supporting beam width. So here we have to keep minimum anchorage length of LD plus 10D, which is generally provided everywhere. And we can see that bottom reinforcement has just reached till the face of this primary beam, whereas top reinforcement has been provided a complete anchorage length. So for that, let us see first this beam, then we will see how we can enter our formula in Excel sheet. So now here I have made a cross section. Here this beam, I will change the color for this. This beam which you are seeing in green color is our beam 141, and this is beam 7 and this is beam 1. So here we can see that top reinforcement will have an anchorage length, correct? Will travel through beam 141 and then we'll have again anchorage over here in other beam. So how to enter this in Excel sheet? First of all, we know that the beam width is of 230 mm on both the sides, correct? Now we have to enter our formula in such a way so that Excel can check whether we have to provide this L or not. So how we can do that is, first of all, we know that this complete length is LD plus 10D. Now in our schedule, we have beam 141 over here. The top reinforcement is of 10 mm diameter. So for 10 mm, let us calculate what will be LD plus 10D. So for us, LD is 36 into 10 plus 10 into 10, that is 10D. So this becomes 460. So we know that beam width is 230, from which 40 mm cover will be minus. So this will become 190. So the rest of the thing, whichever is left, will become as this L. So how Excel will know this? We will enter our formula. You can see this here. This length, the length which is highlighted by blue color, will be equal to LD plus 10D. This formula is written wrong over here. I will correct it. This is LD plus 10D. So this is LD plus 10D minus, in brackets, beam width minus cover. So how we will enter this? We will check a condition that if the width of beam on which our secondary beam is resting is less than LD plus 10D. So if the beam width is less than LD plus 10D, then this length should be what? Here it is written, LD plus 10D minus beam width minus cover. So what is this beam width minus cover? That is this distance which is in yellow. So but obviously from LD plus 10D, when this length will be subtracted, we will get the length of this blue bar. So what we have to do is LD plus 10D minus beam width minus cover. If we don't have such condition, then what we have to do is, we don't want this projection, so it will be zero. Now what about this reinforcement? We have to again check here. If beam width is less than LD plus 10D, again beam width is less than LD plus 10D, then what length should it consider? Beam width minus cover. If beam width will be more than LD plus 10D, then what this length should be? It should be LD plus 10D. I hope so you are clear. with this, now let us see how we can enter this in Excel sheet. So for that, I have moved to my Excel sheet. I will enter here beam number as 141. Let us take the length of this beam from the drawing, which is something around 2.84. But let us check again. DLI. Now, what this length B will be? Again, we have to provide an if condition to check this length. Then we will add this complete length of B 141. Then again, we will give if condition to this beam width. So how we will proceed? First, if beam towards left is less than LD plus 10 into D. Then what we have to do? We have to do beam width minus cover. If condition is not satisfied, then this length will be equal to LD plus 10 into D. This is our first condition, right? Now we have to add the length of beam 141. So I will give a plus, then again I will add this, then again plus, then again I will add the same formula, but I will take now beam of right. So I will again enter the formula. If beam towards right, that is this one, beam towards right is less than LD plus 10 into D, then what we have to do? We have to do beam width minus cover. Now again a comma. If this condition is not satisfied, then LD plus 10 into D divided by 1000. So these marks end of my formula. Then I will again hit enter. So you can see we have got one length over here as 3.22. Now again, what I will do is, I will just copy this formula, Control C, and I will just paste it in this cell. But what I have to keep in mind is, I have to change the beam condition. Wherever I will have L, I will replace it by N in the formula, so that that cell will be selected. Wherever we will find L, I will replace it with N. Okay, so there is nothing again left, so I will hit again enter. So you can see we have got here some length. Now let us check whether this 3.22 is correct or not. So I will just go over here, I will press dimension, and I will check this length. I'm not sure whether I have made it up to scale or not, but let us check. So this, yes, it is up to scale. This length is 3.22. So if you are just starting with this concept, so I prefer you that please draw the section and then enter formula in Excel. If you are well versed with the general drawings and your mind is very sharp enough, then you can directly put the formula in Excel. You don't need to draw any kind of sections over there. The next question is, how we can add shape of bar here? So for that, what we can do, I will make this cell more bigger, then I will click on insert over here. Now go to shapes, take a line, as you all know, d square by 162 into the total length of the bar, correct? If not, then leave it as it is. Now what we have to do is, if we will keep it as it is, the formula won't act perfectly. So what we have to do is, we have to use some dollar symbols. For example, I don't want this row to change, so I will hit a dollar here, because this x1 is my this cell. If I will drag the formula down, my row will automatically get changed. So I don't want my row to get changed, so I will use a dollar. Now, if I will drag my formula towards right, this column of the diameter will keep on changing. So I don't want this column to be changed, so I will press because we don't have any kind of vertical projections over here. So I hope you are clear with this topic. So we will see some of the more beams in upcoming lectures. If you like this video, please do like, share and subscribe. And thanks for watching this video.